Matt, where are you?
I am in Wise Buddha.
Oh, just behind the BBC.
Not far, not far.
Yeah, I know those guys. I've been there. Been there a few times.
You've been here. It's a great place to be.
Now, I've had to write your name down phonetically today, Matt Cardle, because I always call you Matt Cardell. Because
a lot of people do.
I think that just sounds a little more classy.
Yeah, it's a little bit, what is it, Hannibal Rising Cardell? I don't know if you've seen that film.
I haven't seen it, but Matt Cardell, it sounds a bit more international, a bit more yeah. Man of intrigue.
Yeah, I know. Maybe I'll just change it. I'll swap the E and the L around. Why not?
Yeah. But anyway, that's up to you. Anyway, look, you're back. Welcome back. And I see they're running. I've just seen on ITV, they're running a nice promo for you being on Lorraine tomorrow.
That's right. That's right. I'm on Lorraine in the morning talking about the album as it is out in the morning. Tomorrow morning. Wow.
I've got to be honest, we didn't bother with a promo for you.
Oh, okay. No, don't worry. It's all good. It's all good.
We should have done because you're Southampton's... Matt Cardell, aren't you? Matt Cardell.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's people from Southampton call me Cardell. That's it. I moved away and got called Cardell.
So where are you actually from in Southampton?
Oh, now you're asking me questions that I don't have answers to. I was very little when I left Southampton, Alex. I was only four, I'm going to say three perhaps. I moved to Bristol. And then after Bristol, I moved to Essex.
Ah, right. So you're not really Southampton. We've just put that tag on it because we're broadcasting from Southampton. So,
well, I mean, I was born in Southampton. That is a stone-cold fact, but I just don't know where. I'm sure in the children's hospital somewhere.
Okay. Now, look, you've apparently you've opened up about your addiction, and that's what Lorraine would be going for tomorrow, won't she? Is this live, by the way? Have you pre-recorded the thing with Lorraine?
Oh, no, it was pre-recorded this morning.
Ah, right. Because I watched that, and it's as live.
It is as live.
And you always think it's live. But so did she dig on the addiction? Did they try and get you to break up on air and cry and all that
no,
kind of...
No. Lorraine is an absolute angel. She's been wonderful ever since we first met back in 2010. 11, it would have been. No, you know, I've opened up about it. I think the thing is, Alex, this album has come from that experience.
This is why
I'm sat here today is because of my trouble with addiction to prescription drugs and alcohol and my recovery and everything that came with that, the darkness and the light, you know, it's all been poured directly back into this album. So I have no qualms. There's no shame in any of these circumstances.
Okay, look, I've got to ask you. So there you are. You're doing really well. 2010, X Factor. You're on the highest rated series ever, as you know. Mm-hmm. Over 19 million viewers. You got a number one in the charts. You're all over the TV. Mm-hmm. So all your dreams come true. Why? And this is what a lot of the general public don't understand. Mm-hmm. Why do you start getting addicted? What did you start getting addicted to first, by the way?
Well, first, I mean... Look, I'll put it to you this way. I think somebody who finds himself in a place like the Priory or any rehab facility, you don't get there if you enjoy long walks with the dog and knitting and reading books of an evening. You know, I'm a very hedonistic person. I grew up very, very heady. So when I came off the show and you're given all this money and there's all this opportunity, all this stuff around you, you know, drugs, drink, women, it's all there for the taking. If you're that way inclined, it's a very difficult situation to survive. But for me, it was through struggle. It wasn't a party lifestyle that took me down in the end. I mean, don't get me wrong, I was partying a lot, you know, as were a lot of people around me. You know, I was with Sony for 18 months, and that was my dream come true, was to become a recording artist, be signed to a major label. That's something I worked at for nearly 18 years of my life to get into that position. And then I got it, and then it was taken away from me within 18 months. You know, that album sold over platinum, over 300,000 copies. It was a very, very successful album. For a number of reasons, I left Sony. It hurt, though. You know, it hurt me deeply. And
so you crashed.
I completely crashed.
Okay,
yeah.
Let me ask you this, because we're limited on time, and I'd love to speak to you for a lot longer, Matt, and I really thank you for opening up. Is there any counselling that goes with getting on X Factor, being dropped from X Factor if you don't make it through to the end? And do Sony, or like the biggest record company in the world, do they offer you counselling, or do you just go in and they say, sorry, we're not renewing your contract, you are yesterday?
I mean, it's very much along the latter part of that sentence. It's, you know, you don't have, you want to hope that you have good friends and good family, and a good team around you. You know, at the time, my manager was the closest person to me. And even our relationship was struggling, you know, so you don't have that. You just want to hope that you can keep your head on your shoulders. I was unable to do that, and I'll freely admit that. You know, it was one of those things. I couldn't bear the way I was feeling, and I did something about it. I medicated those feelings. I numbed that pain, and I carried on.
How bad did it get, Matt?
I mean, it could have gone all the way. Look, we are losing people left, right, and centre in the public eye due to prescription drugs and alcohol abuse. I mean, I could start to name them, but I'll be here all night. You know, it is such a potent, lethal combination of benzo and alcohol, Valium and alcohol, Tramadol and alcohol. All this stuff is so muscle relaxants mixed with alcohol is equals lethal. And it came close far too many times.
When you see Ant McPartland in the newspapers looking like a broken, shattered man, this lovely, likable, talented, funny guy who's been king of ITV along with Dec for years, do you think I know what he's going through?
Yeah, on a feelings level, yes. I mean, I don't know what it's like to be, you know, the ITV golden boy and in the public eye so persistently and consistently the way that Ant has been for the last decade. You know, that I can't relate to. I can relate to the public eye, of course, but not on that kind of arena. But with regards to the way that he's feeling, with regards to the drugs and the alcohol, then hell yeah, I know exactly how that feels, and it's not good.
Well, look, we're really thrilled that you're out the other side. The new album is out tomorrow, the 27th. I would have thought the fourth album, it would have come out on May the 4th. The Star Wars fans would have loved that.
Yeah, May the 4th be with you and all that. No, I know. This just happens to be when it comes out. I'm so excited. Look, I'm more proud of this album than I am of anything I've ever done in my entire life, you know, including, you know, beat the things that we were just talking about. This means absolutely everything to me, this album.
And it's on Sony Music. What's happened there then?
I know. I mean, we were flirting with a couple of labels in the run-up to kind of nailing this onto disc. And then to wind up on the very label that I left. Even in one of the meetings we had, there was a question of, like, you know, how do you feel about coming back? And I'm like, are you joking? Like, as if I was going to say, yeah, well, I'm not happy about what happened.
Did they rehire you in the room they dumped you in?
No, that, I mean, I was sat in a very posh suite in the Mondrian on Sunset Boulevard when they did let me go. I mean, it was such a backwards, you know, I was there with my manager. We were living there for about 4 or 5 months writing my second album when I found out that I wasn't with Sony anymore. And I was like, but what about all this? What am I doing here?
Yeah, they say, you'll get the bill. Don't worry. We'll send you the bill for that.
Sure, I did.
Yeah. Listen, Matt, I think it's wonderful. I should be glued to Lorraine tomorrow. Congratulations on beating your addiction, and
good luck with the album.
The album's called Time to Be Alive, and it certainly is for you. The first single lifted from the album is Desire. We're going to play it now, and Matt Cardle would like to thank you for not being Matt Cardle anymore.
Thank you so much.
Cheers.